स्टूडेंट टाइप स्मार्ट काम करो, सब्सक्राइब के साथ साथ बेल आइकन भी दबाओ।
हे गाइस, वेलकम टू मैनूवर। आई एम एडवोकेट निशा लोटिया एंड माय टुडेस सेशन इज फॉर ऑल द लॉ एस्पायरेंट्स हु विल अपीयर फॉर द एंट्रेंस एग्जाम्स इन 2021। Students, as we know that Contract Act is the most dominating part of the Legal Aptitude section. So in my today's session, I will discuss the sure shot questions from the Contract Act, which will boost your knowledge and thereby your scores. But before getting started, let me tell you, during this pandemic, Pennuvar is also offering the online lectures, which will help you to prepare yourself because by 2021, when your exams will be scheduled in the month of April or May, the vaccines will be out and everything will be at proper places. Guys, we are located at three places, that is Borivali, Dadar, Vasai, and very shortly, by God's grace, we are coming to Pune also. But right now we are only conducting the live lectures, which is online, guys. And for that, you can contact us on 8828581455, or you can WhatsApp also, guys. And you can visit us at manuveredu.com. Okay, this is our website. For any query related to the, you know, examinations, related to joining us, you can definitely, you know, contact us, and our admins will be really there to help you. So guys, as I told you, that contract is one of the most dominating part. When I say dominating part, I say maximum of the questions are asked from the Contract Act. So let's start with the first question. I'll read the direction first. Each question consists of a legal proposition or principles, hereinafter referred to as principle and facts. Now, mostly you will get questions based on the principles and facts, guys. Now, these principles have to be applied to the given facts to arrive at the most reasonable conclusion. Such principles may not be true in the real sense. Okay, they are not true in the real sense. Yet you have to conclusively assume them to be true for the purposes of this section. Now, before getting started with the first question, I would like to draw your attention. Whenever it is a principle fact question, you have to keep one thing in your mind, and that is the most key factor. You cannot write your answer out of this principle. Your answer has to be based on the principle. All the social or religious answer or suggestions will never be your answers, okay? Wo jo sare options honge na, they will never be your answers, guys. This is the thing you have to, you know, keep in your mind. The easiest way to come to the best accurate answer is that aapka jo principle ka language hoga, jo legal language hoga, that will be same there for your options also. So be very, you know, clear in your mind when it comes to the principle and facts questions, that you know you have to answer only as per the principle. You're not allowed to go out of the principle. Now let's start with the first question, and I would request you that after I read the principle, facts and the options, you pause the video, you know, try to find out the correct answer by yourself, and then come back to the explanation and check whether your answer was correct or incorrect. Okay, so let's get started with the first question for the day. When one person signifies to another his willingness to do or to abstain from doing anything with a view to obtaining the assent of that other to such act or abstinence, he is said to make a proposal. The expression of willingness, I desire, results in a valid proposal only when it is made or addressed to some person. Now, if you are attending my lectures and all, then you will understand that this part is nothing but it is a definition of the word proposal. So in the examination, you don't have to, you know, reread the definition part, because ek baat samjho, definition kabhi change nahi hota hai. So never waste your time in rereading it. You know, instead get used to these words and these definitions, whereby aapka, you know, kya hoga ki aapka reading bahut fast ho jayega, and which will, you know, save lots of our time. Now, this is the most important condition what they have laid is, the expression of willingness, I desire, results in a valid proposal only when it is made or addressed to someone. Now, the essentials of a valid proposal is what? Nothing but communication. And communication what? To some another person. Okay, so this is the theme of the principle over here. Now, let's go to the facts. X makes the following statement in an uninhabited hall. Okay, I wish to sell my mobile phone for rupees 1000. Now, which of the following derivations is correct? Now, the word uninhabited means what? It is an empty hall. There's nobody over there. Okay, so this point is to be, you know, noted over here. Now, the four options is X made a statement that resulted in a promise. X made a statement that resulted in a proposal. X made a statement that did not result in any proposal. X made a statement that resulted in an agreement. Now guys, you have to pause the video here and, you know, find out the answer by yourself and then get back to the explanation. Now it is said in the principle that, you know, proposal, whatever you're making has to be communicated to somebody. Now when we see the facts, it is saying that a guy is making a proposal, but he is, telling it in an uninhabited hall, means there's nobody in the hall. So there is nobody at the receiving end. So can this amount to a proposal? Does this go with the definition or with the condition of the proposal? X made a proposal that resulted in a promise. Promise to ho hi nahi sakta, because promise is what? It is related to acceptance. Ab acceptance ki to koi baat hi nahi hui hai. So promise is not my correct answer. X made a statement that resulted in a proposal. Now this also cannot be my correct answer, because he has made a proposal when there's nobody in the hall. So there's no communication, there's no other party. So this also cannot be my correct option. X made a statement that did not result in any proposal. Yes, this looks to be good. Then also I'll look for the fourth option. X made a statement that resulted in an agreement. This is no way possible, because sirf proposal ki baat hui hai, acceptance ki bhi baat nahi hui hai, agreement ki bhi baat nahi hui hai. So this cannot be my answer choice, because ye kuch principle mein mention hi nahi hua hai. Okay, so the C statement, X made a statement that did not result in any proposal, is the correct answer choice. Okay, that is the correct derivation what we see from the principle mention. So this is the way this should be your approach when it comes to the legal aptitude section, guys. Going ahead with the second question. Minor's agreement is void from the very beginning. Now this is based on the legal, Latin maxim, that is void ab initio. Okay, it is based on the, maxim that is void ab initio, means, void from the very beginning. When you enter, the principle says, aap jab minor ke sath agreement enter karenge, then it is, void from the very beginning itself. It can never be validated, okay? It cannot be enforced in the court of law. The facts are, a boy of 16 years of age agrees to buy a camera from B, who is a girl of 21 years of age. Now, when we see a boy is 16 years of age, means he is a minor, because he is below 18 years, correct? Now, which of the following derivation is correct? Now, if you see, the principle is telling when you enter with a contract, in an agreement with a minor, it is void ab initio. So, does their contract exist or not? Okay, so let's see the answer choices. There arises a contract between A and B to sell or buy the camera in question. There arises an enforceable agreement. Now, enforceable agreement is nothing but what, your contract? Correct. This is the other way of asking. Okay, so there arises an enforceable agreement between A and B to sell or buy the camera in question. Okay, there does not arise any contract between A or B to sell or buy the camera in question. There arises a voidable contract between A and B to sell or buy the camera in question. Now guys, you see, it is clearly mentioned in the principle that when you enter into an agreement with a minor, it is void ab initio. So, agar agreement hi nahi hai, to contract ki to baat hi nahi ho sakti. So, the first two options, it does not stand in. Okay. Now, in the fourth option, they are talking about the voidable contract. Now, there are three types of contract, correct? The first is the valid, then the voidable, and the void. Now, yahan pe jab contract nahi hai, to voidable ki to baat hi nahi ho sakti. But this is just for your knowledge. Voidable contracts are the optionable contracts, in the sense the agreed party can have an option to go to the court if his if he has signed the contract out of pressure or things like that. So voidable contract to ye ho hi nahi sakta, because it is clearly mentioned that minor ke sath agar aap agreement karonge, so that is void ab initio. So option C looks to be perfect. There does not arise any contract between A or B to buy or sell the camera in question. Am I clear about it? So this is a direct application of the principle. Now Let's go to the third question. A contract which is duly supported by real and lawful consideration is valid notwithstanding the fact that the consideration is inadequate. Okay, so the quantum of the consideration is for the parties to decide at the time of making a contract and not for the courts to decide when the contract is sought to be enforced. Now, for example, guys, if X and Y is entering into a contract, so X and Y quantum means the price hoga jo bhi cheez ka hai. If we are talking about a flat, to flat ka jo price rahega. We are talking about a car, to car ka jo price rahega. That is to be decided by X and Y. It can be more than the market price also, and it can be less than the market price also. The courts does not have to interfere with it. Court ka kaam kya hai ki bas kuch consideration hai ki nahi, kuch amount hai ki nahi, kuch quantum hai ki nahi, bas wohi dekhne kya. Because if it is you know, without any quantum, without any amount, then it will become a gift. Correct? So what will happen? Then it will not be there in this type of a question under the contract act. So guys, you have to very well read the, you know, questions, guys. I'll read ahead. An agreement to which the consent of the promisor is freely given is not void merely because the consideration is inadequate. But the inadequacy of the consideration may be taken into account by the court in determining whether the consent of the promisor was given freely or not. Now over here, the court ka kaam kya hai? They will just see whether the consent is free or not. Okay? Ki koi coercion to koi use nahi ho gaya hai na? You know, koi undue influence to use nahi ho gaya hai. So the court will see all those facts. But the quantum ka kaam uska nahi hai court ka. And quantum can be anything, guys. It can be more than the market price also. It can be the less than the market price also. In any which ways, agar more bhi hai ya less bhi hai, the contract is absolutely valid till the time the consent is a free consent. Okay. So inadequacy of the consideration is not the court's purview, guys. Now let's go to the facts. A agrees to sell his mobile worth rupees 20,000 for rupees 100 only to B. A's consent is freely given. Okay, so freely ho gaya, to aapka kya hoga? This agreement is absolutely okay. Which of the following derivations is correct? There is a contract between A and B. There is no contract between A and B because consideration is not adequate. Now, principle mein clearly mention kar raha hai ki quantum kuch bhi ho, you know, quantum is also, if it is inadequate, then also the contract will become valid. Okay, so ye to apna kya hai, this option does not look good to me. There is no contract between A and B because a mobile phone worth rupees 20,000 cannot be sold just for rupees 100. And remember, guys, it is a suggestion. Now this suggestion is never your legal answer. Okay, so this is also not a good answer option. None of the above is also not a good choice. There is a contract between A and B. It is absolutely valid. Now, you know, on the face value of it, you can say, you know, ki are 20,000 ka mobile hai, you know, he is ready to sell only for 100. How is it possible? But legally, when you sign something, guys, it is said that you have to perform your part of a contract. So only the elders say, do not sign the document without reading it. Okay, so there is a contract between A and B because the consideration agar kitna bhi inadequate ho, but that is not the criteria for an invalid agreement. Going ahead with the next question. When one person signifies to another his willingness to do or to abstain from doing anything with a view to obtaining the assent of that person to such an act or abstinence, he is said to made a proposal. Now guys, proposal ka definition bahut hi important hai. Every year you see, you know, one or two questions from this. So I would request all of you to, you know, understand the definition of proposal, you know, and try to read it as many times as you can, you know, 5 to 6 times, so that aapka reading bahut smooth ho jayega by the time the exam approaches. Now let's go to the facts of the question. Ramanuj telegraphed to Shyam Sundar writing, will you sell me your Rolls Royce car? Telegram, the lowest cash price. Shyam Sundar also replied by telegram, lowest price for the car is rupees 20 lakhs. Ramanuj immediately sent his consent through telegram stating, I agree to buy the car for rupees 20 lakhs asked by you. Shyam Sundar refused to sell the car. Okay, Shyam Sundar refused to sell the car. Now, the options are, he cannot refuse to sell the car because the contract has already been made. He can refuse to sell the car because it was only invitation to offer and not the real offer. It was not a valid offer because willingness to enter into a contract was absent and none of the above. Now guys, when you're looking at the facts of the question, you know, it is telling you that they are just exchanging the selling price. Okay, they are just exchanging the selling price. Now it is a very well settled law that whenever you are, you know, quoting some price, it does not mean that you actually want to deal with it. Okay, so over here, these kind of talks are what only, they are only invitation to offer and not the real offer. Okay, they are only just the invitation to offer. Jaise aapke government tenders hote hai. Okay, government tenders hote hai. Jaise aapko koi college ka, you know, aapko form milta hai ya koi catalog milta hai. So they are what, if you receive the form from the college, you know, if you are paying 1,000 rupees and you get that form and you fill it, to kya aapki seat book ho jati hai? No, okay. So these kinds of offers are what? Only the invitation to offers. They are not the real offers. Okay, so till the time it is an invitation to offer, it is upon you to withdraw from that, you know, offer. It is not at all illegal, guys. So he cannot refuse to sell the car because the contract has already been made. There's no contract as of yet. Okay, so this is not my correct answer choice. He can refuse to sell the car because it was only invitation to offer and not the real offer. Yes, this looks good to me. It was not a valid offer because willingness to enter into a contract was absent. Okay, but the B answer choice is much better than the C one. Agar B nahi hota, then C would be a correct option. None of these, okay, so none of these is not your answer. So B is the correct answer choice. Moving to last question for the day. With the counter proposal made by the party, the original offer ceases to exist. Now, with the counter proposal, in the sense what, if Mr. A will ask Mr. B that I want to sell you my laptops, say for 1 lakh rupee. Now, B will say, I will buy your laptop only for say 90,000. So, now over here, the 90,000 is your new price. Correct? So, ye kya ho gaya aapka? New price is what? Your counter offer. That is what, your guys? Your counter offer. Counter offer aate hi, the original offer will cease to exist. This is what the principal is trying to mention. First, when A made the proposal to B, guys, A was your offerer, correct? And B was the offeree. Anybody who is on the receiving end is your offeree, correct? Double E lagta hai usko. But now, when A is talking about 1 lakh rupee, correct? A is talking about 1 lakh rupee and B is now talking about 90,000. So, over here, when B will ask A for 90,000, so what will happen is, A will become your offeree. जो अब तक ऑफरर था वो आपका क्या हो जाएगा? ऑफर ही हो जाएगा. और बी क्या हो जाएगा? ऑफरर हो जाएगा. नाउ बिकॉज ही इज गिविंग यू एन न्यू ऑफर. सो द प्रिंसिपल इज टेलिंग यू, विद द काउंटर ऑफ प्रपोजल मेड बाय द पार्टी, द ओरिजिनल ऑफर सीजेस टू एग्जिस्ट. सीजेस मीन्स व्हाट गाइस? इट एंड्स. ओके, इट एंड्स, इट एग्जिस्ट नो मोर. द फैक्ट्स ऑफ द केस आर, Badal offered to sell his car to Pranav at price of rupees 3 lakhs. Pranav replies that he is ready to buy the car at 2.5 lakhs only. Badal refuses to sell at that price. Later, Pranav goes to Badal with rupees 3 lakhs to buy the car. Is the offer to rupees 3 lakhs still valid? Okay, so let's see the options. The offer of rupees 3 lakhs is not valid with a counter offer of Pranav being made. The offer of rupees 3 lakhs still stands for Pranav to buy the car. The offer stands as it was made by the owner of the car, that is Badal himself. The offer can be renegotiated by the buyer and the seller. Now the last option, that is the renegotiated, aisa to kuch principle mein mention hi nahi hai, so this can never be our answer choice, guys. The offer stands as it was made by the owner of the car, that is Badal himself, aisa bhi kuch principle mein mention nahi hai, so this will also not be your answer choice. Okay, the let's you know see the first two options there. The offer of rupees 3 lakhs is not valid with the counter offer of Pranav being made. Yes, this is my correct answer choice because the principal is telling me with the counter offer made by the party, the original offer ends, correct? So the A looks good to me. The offer of rupees 3 lakhs still stands for Pranav to buy the car. Okay, it does not stand because counter offer hote hi kya ho jayega, aapka original offer end ho jayega. So option A is my correct answer choice. So guys, this is the thing, you have to, you know, read the principle properly and, you know, get used with all the legal terms and proposal, you know, contract mein se guys, the questions on consideration, proposal, acceptance, these are bahut hi important topics hai. Do go through properly, do understand, you know, take a correct mentorship and legal aptitude section can be really scoring in your entrance exams. Okay, guys. So, Admanuver can help you with the books, the mock test, which are the replicas, you know, which are the absolute replicas of your examination day. And we have the sectional course also, guys, and we have the full course also. So the Manuver has the entire package, guys. So it will be very helpful during this pandemic. You know, you can prepare yourself sitting at home and being safe at the same time. We have the live lectures conducted by all the, you know, experienced faculties who, you know, who appear papers every year. So they have... they know the proper types of questions, what are you going to encounter on your D-Day. And, you know, they are very well groomed for this. For online program, guys, you can call us on 8828581455 or you can visit us at manuveredu.com law entrance. And we are located at Borivali, Dadar and Vasai. And very shortly, we are coming to Pune also. So, guys, do subscribe the channel. And do share with your friends and, you know, relatives who are appearing for the exams, because we're going to come with many, you know, of the informational and, you know, educative series which will help you in your preparations. All the best. Stay safe. Stay home. Thank you.